Superstar, do you want to be?
Hi guys, this is Matida Dead with another episode of Mondo Squalido, and today we're tackling one of the films from the Traci Lords box set put out by Alpha France. This was sent to me by DeadPorkChops, whose link will be down below. There are no videos up at the moment, but hopefully he will start making videos again. Today's title is from the 80s, it's from 1985 to be exact, directed by a guy called Gary Graver, who directed this film under the name of Robert McCallum. And today's film is Dynamite Sex Girls is another title for the film Suzie Superstar 2, and it stars Traci Lords, Ginger Lynn, Ron Jeremy, and John Leslie. After some genuinely fantastic opening title music, we're introduced to two characters played by John Leslie and Ron Jeremy, and they're playing a little bit of golf. Unfortunately, John's game is a little bit off because he misses his Suzie.
You miss Suzie? Yeah, I miss her.
He's also starting to think that he's a little bit of an arsehole.
Maybe I'm an asshole. What do you think?
You bastard music. After getting a bit too frustrated from his lack of form, he has a chance encounter with a stranger in a shower. And then they fuck. Unfortunately, the woman's husband walks in on them and...
Who are you?
After being knocked the fuck out by funny animation, Ron and John decide to go for a jog.
I've been thinking of what you said yesterday on a golf course. What's that, boss?
John phones up Traci Lords with a little bit of an invite.
The crew's on my yacht. I want you to clear your throat and we'll talk over some business.
Traci is indulging in some pleasure time with her friend while she's on the phone, and then we get a lesbian scene. So after a little bit of rug munching, we cut to the next day where everyone's on a boat, John's boat to be exact, and there's some light entertainment going on. The great thing about John is he looks after his talent, and he's very, very hands-on. And you know what this is going to lead to. After this, we go to a place called... where Traci is performing live. This film does need a soundtrack release though. After an almost out of place transition effect... we're introduced to an old gangster sort of fellow who wants to meet up with Traci.
Well, I'd like to meet her. You know I have a predilection for thrushes.
Oh, and he wants John dead.
I think it is time that I put out my personal contract on Z.W. McCain.
Meanwhile, John needs to get to the studio to see Traci himself, but there's a tiny bit of car trouble.
You know, if you want me to drive a better car, you should pay me more money.
As they're driving to the studio, some random goons decide to follow them.
Hey, wake up, there's no green car over there, let's follow it.
It turns out to be the gangster's henchmen, and... holy fucking shit. I'd say best crash ever, but there actually wasn't one. Thankfully, John and his friend survive, and they decide to go find a phone. John and his guitarist randomly come across four naked women in the woods... playing a bit of volleyball. Fuck you, movie. The girls, shocked, understandably run away, and John thinks of the thing that any normal person would.
Why don't we follow them? Maybe wherever they're going, they have a phone.
So this being a porno, this leads to...
No one's allowed to wear any clothes.
And that goes for you guys, too.
Which then leads to...
And we decided that we might break one little rule.
Yeah, we might just make you our special guest for today.
That is, if you can perform.
Perform?
Fuck.
Then we can use the phone.
If we all get off.
After some very careful thought...
Okay, we'll do it.
But before that happens, John inquires about the... musical talents.
Well, we play flutes. Skin flutes.
Yeah, real subtle. So, of course...
No!
So after that chance encounter... it kind of goes all fame. So Traci meets up with this gangster and they talk about John.
Yes, Mr. Z.W. McCain. Not the nicest man in the music business.
He basically tells her that he's bought out her contract because John owes him. In a few different ways, Traci and this guy share some genuinely fantastic dialogue.
He's on the continent.
Which continent?
One of the far continents. But that's not important now.
We then go to Vegas. Where we have one of the best musical performances in 80s cinema history. Wasn't this guy just with John? John and Ron, which I've realised is sounding like a comedy duo, are actually waiting backstage. John is understandably confused.
Old manager? What the hell's going on here? Could someone tell me?
The gangster walks in and there's some heated discussion.
What about territory?
I own this place.
I own her.
Traci gets a little bit deep.
Nobody owns me.
Shut up, Barbara.
No, you shut up. I'm not a pawn.
And Ron gets kind of...
I thought a pawn was a fish or something.
That's a prawn.
Oh, Ron. They then get escorted out of the building by a blues brother.
Luigi, Mr. VW and his friend would like to see more of our marvellous Nevada desert.
Back at the show, Traci gets talking to her guitarist. He seduces her with some beautiful guitaring. Which then causes Traci to fantasize about him. And it seems like that they've fallen for each other. John and Ron get left in the desert, stark bollock naked. John is understandably quite angry.
Don't say a thing. Don't say a fucking thing.
So we're with John and Ron in the desert for a little bit. Understand. They try to hitch a ride, but unfortunately...
Oh, they're limp.
They decide to go to a place that Ron's friend runs, which is a ranch. When they get there, they get teased a little bit. But thankfully, since Ron knows this woman, they get offered a little bit of hospitality.
You boys look like you could use a bath.
And a good drink.
And some spaghetti.
And maybe... a good fuck.
Yeah, it's pretty much obvious what happens next.
Slower, slower, faster.
After being helped by these lovely women, we get another out of place transition effect. We cut to 2 months later and John and Ron are auditioning singers.
If things work out, you'll be hearing from me.
Thank you, Mr. McCain.
It doesn't seem to be going to plan. But thankfully, one of the women, played by Ginger Lynn, from the ranch, decides to turn up.
Tina Hickenlooper? From the Lickety Split Ranch?
And after another genuinely fantastic song... I can't get enough of it all. John has finally found his Suzie. I can't get enough of it all. After the performance... Thankfully, the gangster wants in.
Are you serious?
Trust me.
And that's the end of the film. Dynamite Sex Girls is an entertaining and genuinely awesome adult flick. It's got an absolutely fantastic score, a great cast, entertaining dialogue. The comedy was actually really, really good in this. Some great lines. The scenes were actually really, really well done as well. Nothing too cheesy or anything like that. Another thing that makes this film that little bit more fascinating is the fact that, you know, it was Traci Lords, it was 1985. She was still underage when she did this film. You can see how she got away with it. You know, she was arrested in 1986, I believe, a year later. The guy who directed it, I was reading him up on IMDb. You know, he was linked with people like Orson Welles. And he actually got sued by Orson Welles' daughter or something like that for auctioning off one of his Oscars, which was given to him as a gift, or he claims it was. And yeah, all around, it's an entertaining flick. If you can pick this set up, I'd grab it as soon as you can. You're probably going to pay a little bit more for it because this is an old set. Plus, the fact that it's, you know, got some Traci Lords films on when she was not necessarily legal, it's a really good item to have. And yeah, it's entertaining. All these films obviously have like the French dub, they've got the French titles, but no, I thought this was an entertaining flick, and this is why Traci Lords is Scream Queen. English motherfucker, thanks for fucking sending me this set. I know I'm going to enjoy the other films, so yeah, highly, highly, highly recommended. That's it for another episode of Mondo Squalido. If you've got any questions, feel free to ask, and if you've got any recommendations or anything to have, or anything to add, I should say, let me know. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video, and until the next one, guys, you're all awesome.